All right, I've got a new smoke formula for you to try. This is going to have a new additive in it called terephthalic acid. This is not like anything else you've seen before. It is not like those rocket candy mixtures, which, although effective, and those aren't nearly as good as this because of the fact that having wax in this formula lets us put it in any containers we want. It lets us store it for a period of time without it absorbing moisture. So this is, of course, better than any of the rocket candy mixtures. One of the things this is going to have in it is potassium nitrate, just like the other formula I showed you. It's going to have 60 grams of potassium nitrate. It's going to have 40 grams of powdered sugar, and it's going to have 40 grams of terephthalic acid and 30 grams of wax, which is melting right now. All right, first thing we're going to do is add our potassium nitrate. I've already ground it to save some time. We need 60 grams potassium nitrate. That was actually 70 there. Let's get some out. There's 61. Good enough. All right, we're going to put that in our measure cup here where we're keeping all of our ingredients. There's 60 grams of potassium nitrate. Keep in mind, if you make this, be aware of the MSDS, or Material Safety Data Sheet, for all the chemicals you're using. All right, there's 17. 29. As you know, powdered sugar is pretty harmless. There isn't a whole lot of danger to potassium nitrate. Terephthalic acid does have some dangers. You're supposed to keep it away from oxidizers, which we're not going to do. We're going to put it in our smoke bomb formula with the potassium nitrate. You're supposed to keep terephthalic acid away from heat sources. We're not going to do that either because we're going to ignite it. And you're not supposed to breathe it. It causes a lung irritation, and you're not supposed to get it on your skin. So keep those dangers in mind. Make sure you are aware of the dangers of the chemicals you're working with. All right, let's add the 40 grams of terephthalic acid. There's 42, it's good enough. The terephthalic acid clumps together. So what we're going to do is run it through our coffee grinder real quick just to thin it out a little bit to make it mix easier. All right, and the way I'm going to mix this stuff up is I'm going to put it all in this old mayonnaise jar. Putting it in a mayonnaise jar helps me be able to mix it. Keep in mind, when you're mixing it, when you're grinding up your terephthalic acid, the dangers involved. You're not supposed to be breathing it. I'll clean that coffee mill out later. I don't want to stick my finger in there. Put a lid on it. Now that we've got everything in here. Also, you'll notice one of the things I did not add was the baking soda. Get it all mixed up. All right, let's go ahead and put this in the hot wax. We just stir through till it clumps up. The best part about the formula that I'm using right now versus your typical rock and candy mixture is. This is going to be in a form that we can transfer to other containers. That's especially useful if you want to put it in an old mayonnaise jar or a Gatorade bottle, which is what I do. I put them in Gatorade bottles, and then later on I can put it in paper tubes. This is specifically being made for my flare launcher. That way I can launch flares, put out a lot of smoke. Basically, I want to duplicate signal rounds, smoke signal rounds that cost $30 for 10 rounds. I can make my own a lot cheaper. Alright, we're getting our wax mixed in here. It's nice and clumpy. It's going to be in a granular state. I do not want this clumped together too much. A nice granular state like this is better. Alright, I think that's pretty good right there. What we're going to do now, put this on a paper plate to cool. I might take it in the house and put it in a refrigerator. Take the heat off the hot plate. After it cools, we'll go ahead and make a smoke bomb. And you'll get to see what it looks like with this terephthalic acid. I'll go ahead and tell you ahead of time, it produces a ton of white smoke. Far more than you would expect to see with a regular sugar and potassium nitrate smoke bomb. All right, now we just wait for that to cool. And we'll make our smoke bomb. All right, I've taken our formula out of the refrigerator. I like the granules, the way it's hardened up. Didn't turn into a paste or anything. This will be easy to transfer to a paper tube. It'd be great to use in my flare launcher when I make my smoke signal round. All right, let's make a smoke bomb. We're just going to add 2 or 3 tablespoons of this to this piece of tin foil. Let's add one more. That should be enough. Pinch this in tight. Kind of piece of fuse. I'm using 3mm fuse. I did not look to see if you could get this from smokechemicals.com. I purchased mine on eBay about 3 or 4 months ago. It's just 3mm fuse. Take a look on smokechemicals.com while you're getting your terephthalic acid. You might as well order everything from one place and save yourself some money on shipping. Alright. There. Looks like a big jalapeno pepper with a silver pepper with a green stem. Alright. We're going to go ahead and take this out into the yard and light it, and you'll see how much smoke it makes. It makes a good deal more smoke than plain old saltpeter, sugar, and baking soda. There is no baking soda in this. Lot of volume to that. Still going. All right, we got a little bit of fire from the terephthalic acid, not the terephthalic acid, but rather the potassium nitrate and sugar. I will add a little bit of baking soda to that. Next batch, kind of slow it down a little bit, slow the burn, and it'll work out a lot better. All right. All right, here's one of our smoke rounds. This one does not have nitrocellulose on a fuse. It's just a fuse going into our black powder charge. What we're going to do is launch it, and from here to that stump, farther out, is about 100 yards. So hopefully it'll go at least that distance, and we won't have any problem with it smoking.
Oh, this is loud.
All right, that smoked pretty well.
About 50 yards.
That came out pretty good. And I was aiming straight for the stump. So our lift charge, I have to aim a little bit higher. Our lift charge didn't take it to it, obviously. But that came out good. We'll go ahead and launch a couple more and see how they work out. All right, I've got the next round in. The last cartridge, you've noticed, ignited before it even hit the ground. It was lit. I'm going to hold a little bit higher this time, try to launch it a little bit farther, and try to get it up towards that stump. Well, it didn't quite get a whole lot farther. The smoke cartridges are working great. I'm happy with that. It was my dad's idea to run the fuse all the way to the end of the cartridge. So the fuse is burning all the way through it. That's working really well. They are putting out a lot of smoke, so they're working really well. I'm real happy for that. So we do know that this is a great way to make them. Just follow exactly how I showed you how to make those cartridges on the previous portion of the video, and we shouldn't have any problem with them. Let's go ahead and shoot a few more. Let's go ahead and launch another one. Hopefully this will get it out there. I'll try to aim a little bit higher. The cartridges are a little tight going into the chamber because the cardboard tube is cocked just a little bit, but that's all right. We'll still launch it out there. All right, let's see how this one does. I'm aiming about where my aim is about 20 feet above the stump. All right, it looks like our max distance for these things is gonna be about 60 yards, 50, 60. Looks like it's about 60 yards. It's still putting out a lot of smoke, which is what I wanted. We can still see exactly where the cartridge is. We will be able to retrieve them after we shoot a couple more rounds. I'll go retrieve them and we'll see exactly what they look like after they were fired. And this is with a 10 grain black powder lifting charge. All right, we've got our next round in. What we're gonna do is flip our sight from 50 yards. We're gonna flip it up to where I can set it for 100. And what we're gonna do is aim for that stump. I don't know why, I didn't think about it the very first time we fired. I was using the 50 yard rear sight. Now we're gonna use a 100 yard rear sight and see how close we can get to that stump. It didn't look like it did any better than before, get as far as our range. I'm thrilled that every single cartridge we've fired today has worked great. The smoke rounds are doing really well. They're putting out a lot of smoke. So that's the best part. That's what I'm happiest about, is that our smart cartridges are actually working great. All right, we'll go ahead and fire one more, which is all we have today. And we'll go pick up our rounds and we'll see exactly what they look like, whether or not they're even reusable. All right, we're gonna go ahead and fire the last round. They've all been smoking really well. They've been putting out a lot of smoke. And They've been igniting really well, so we haven't had any problems, any failures to ignite. What we're gonna do now is fire this again at the stump, and I don't believe it'll go any farther than 60 yards. That's what the last ones have went to. Some of them I have a little trouble getting into the chamber because the cardboard tube is cocked a little bit, but it's not preventing us from putting it in. I'm gonna aim about 30 or 40 feet above that stump, see how far we can get it out there. All right, that one there, I aimed about 40 feet above the stump, and it launched it what looks to be about 10 yards maybe in front of it. And again, that one there is putting out a ton of smoke. It's worked great. I'm real happy with the way these cartridges have worked out. They're all igniting perfectly every time. I don't have any nitrocellulose on the end of the fuses or any black powder. It's just a plain black powder fuse that's touching. It's just about touching our 10 grain charge inside our cartridge case. All right, let's go ahead and pick up our rounds. And then we'll look at the condition of them after they've been fired and see whether or not they're even reusable. I've retrieved 4 of the 5 cartridges. The last one I'll have to go look for in a minute. I just wanted to show you these real quick. All 4 of these cartridges are reusable. There's no significant damage from the lifting charge on the bottom. To be able to reuse these, what I'll have to do is just cut the top off and then use a scraper or a brush, clean out any of the smoke compound that's burned up inside, and I'll be able to glue a new wad in it. The next one, of course, will be shorter and will hold less smoke composition, but they will be reusable. I'm real happy with it. The farthest distance the cartridge went up towards the stump is about 85 yards. What I thought was the 60 yard distance is about 75, so they were averaging 75 yards with a 10 grain charge. So I'm real happy with these. They smoked really well. So now you see exactly how you can make your own. And using the methods that I've shown you, you'll get it right the first time. I've done a lot of experimenting to get this to work right. This is a couple months worth of research and coming up with the right formula for the smoke composition and experimenting. Countless rounds fired experimenting. So now you don't have to do that. This is how we did it. It works great. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you like the video, and you'll see the future projects. And don't forget to click like if you enjoyed it. All right, thanks for watching. All right, here are the remnants of our 5 recovered cartridges. You can see the tape hanging off that we put on the cartridges to cover the vent holes. It worked as I wanted. It kept them sealed while we had them stored. And then when it fired and ignited the compound inside, it burned the tape off and allowed it to vent out and prevented the smoke composition from suffocating itself and putting itself out. It worked great. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you can use this information to make your own cartridges without any problems.